God bless you all this morning. What a powerful morning. What a powerful message this morning. I just give God praise and thanks because he is so good. He is faithful. Let us pray. Father, I thank you this morning for this privilege, for this opportunity to share what you have given unto me to give to your people, mighty God. Father, I thank you for your word. I thank you, Lord, that you confirm your word. And I pray, Lord God, that this word would resonate in somebody's spirit today to bring about change, to bring about purification. Bless us together, Lord, I pray, and let the words of my mouth and the meditation of my heart be acceptable in your sight, O Lord, my strength and my redeemer. What I have to bring to you today is what God has given to me, and I'm sure that it will confirm everything that has been said for the last few days, the last 3 days. Is it 3 days from Tuesday anyway until now? Because I've been hearing this devotion over and over and over every morning. But I just give God thanks that I can come in and bring the same word as confirmation for us this morning. Purification. I'm reading from James 4:8, the New King James Version. James 4:8. Draw near to God and he will draw near to you. Cleanse your hands, you sinners, and purify your hearts, you double-minded. And then Isaiah 1:16, wash yourselves, make yourselves clean, put away the evil of your doings from before my eyes, cease to do evil. The title of this devotion this morning is Choose to Live Pure. Choose to live pure. The Holy Spirit can speak to us anytime and at any place. And I got this devotion as I was washing my dishes on Tuesday morning when the fasting, prayer and fasting started. No, it was Sunday. Anyway, when you were focusing on purification. I got this devotion as I was cleaning my dishes. And the Holy Spirit said to me, purification is a process, just as gold goes through a process. He said to me, the first step in purification is true repentance. True repentance. You see, when we truly repent, our hearts are broken before God, and we want to live a life that is pure before him. And just as gold has melted, God told me, just as gold is melted, we must be melted in his presence in order to be remade in his likeness. We sing the chorus all the time, melt me, mold me, fill me, use me. The first thing we say is melt me, because in order for us to be molded, we must be melted. Melt me, mold me, fill me, use me. When we are melted, we can be molded into a vessel that can be filled and be used. So we want God during this purification process to melt us, mold us into the vessel that he wants us to be, and then fill us that we can be used. I was washing my dishes to make them clean, and those dishes had to go through a process before they could be used again. Dishes have to be washed, rinsed, sanitized, and dried before they can be used. If we wait too long to clean the dishes, and we know this, for those of us who don't have dishwashers, we know if we wait too long to clean the dishes, the process may take longer. Certain dishes take longer to clean as the food has now hardened on them, stuck on the dish, and it may have to soak in the water or be scrubbed. There are some things that we have held on to for so long that the process may take a little longer than is necessary, or may take a little longer than before. We may have to soak in the presence of God. And sometimes some of those things that we are holding to that we don't want to let go may have to be scrubbed off of us. Lord, whether we have to be soaked or scrubbed, just clean us up, God. Just clean us up, Father. Hallelujah. According to how much scrubbing is needed, some marks of the scrubbing may be left on the vessel that is being cleaned according to what is being used to scrub. Sometimes you can see the marks where you have scrubbed the vessel. In the same way, some of us carry some scars from our scrubbing. Some of us carry more scars than others, but glory to God, hallelujah. God knows how to smooth out those rough places. Some sponges in the natural, you have sponges that have two sides, one to scrub and one to smooth. God is able to soothe those scars and make us pure. Just as we will not use a dirty dish, we should not expect God to use us in our impure state. In order for us to be purified, there are some things that we must do. And James and Isaiah tells us some of those things that we must do if we choose to live pure. If we choose to live a purified life. James 4 and 8 tells us, draw near to God. We must come to God for purification. We must cleanse. We must desire. We must desire an intimate relationship with God. As we draw near to him, he will draw near to us. We must make the choice first to draw near to God. He draws near to us when we draw near to him, and we must make the first move. Number two, cleanse your hands. The Old Testament priests had to wash their hands before approaching God. Cleansing of the hands is a symbol of outward cleansing. We must recognize the areas in which we need cleansing. What worldly things are we involved in? Have we been dabbling in sin? Can people see our sinful lifestyle? Cleanse ourselves. Number three, purify your hearts. This refers to our inner thoughts, and we heard that from the beginning of the week. Our inner thoughts, our desires, and our motives need to be purified. So we sing the song, and do we mean it? Purify my heart. Make me be as gold and precious silver. Purify my heart, oh God. Set me apart, hallelujah, to do your will. The sin that people can't see, those are our desires and our motives that we need to purify ourselves from. Hidden in the heart, in the place where only God can see. There are some sins that people can see, but there are some sins that the children of God are involved in that need to be purified from us, and only God can see them. We need to purify our hearts because God looks at the heart. And James tells us here, purify your heart. The Bible says, whatever is in the heart will come through the mouth and defile the person. Number four, we should not be double-minded. These are things that we have heard all week. These are just confirmation words because the Holy Spirit gave it to me and I have to give you what he gave me. We should not be double-minded. We must make up our mind to follow Jesus. We have to decide who we will serve, God or man. We have to make the right decisions. We can't be double-minded. We have to choose. Will I live my life for Christ? Will I live a pure life? Or will I continue in the sin that so easily besets me? We have to choose. Isaiah 1:16 tells us some more of the things that we need to do. Number one says, wash you. Make you clean. Talking again about washing. True repentance, turn from sin, turn to God, is when we wash ourselves and make ourselves clean. Jesus' blood makes us clean, but we must choose to live right. Every day we choose to live clean lives. And sometimes we have to receive a fresh cleansing because something that we said, something that we thought, something that we did may have purified our heart, may have purified our spirit. So we ask God to cleanse us again, Lord. Wash us again. Purify my heart, oh God. God is faithful and just to forgive us our sins, the scripture says, and to cleanse us from all unrighteousness. All we need to do is come to him. Draw near to him. call upon him. Recognize, God, I have sinned. Create in me a clean heart, oh God, and renew a right spirit within me. Purge me with hyssop and I shall be clean. Wash me and I shall be whiter than snow. Don't take your Holy Spirit away from me, God. But renew a right spirit within me. Don't cast me away from your presence, Jesus. Lord, purify me again. Hallelujah. Number two, put away the evil of your doings. Put them away. It doesn't say God will remove the evil of your doings. There are things that we have to do. Put away the evil of your doings. We have to put away evil from us. We cannot associate with evil works, and we must have no part in planning or plotting evil against anyone. Put away evil from us. And number three, not only put away evil, but if we have been involved in evil, cease to do it. Hallelujah. Cease to do evil. If we have been involved in any evil thing, if we have been involved in plotting against any brother, any sister, put it away. Cease. Cease from doing it. Cease to do evil. Make a fresh start. Therefore, we see that if we want to be purified, saying we are sorry is not enough. Glory to God. We have to repent for real. True repentance. Real desires to change, to turn. Hallelujah. Saying we are sorry is not enough. The onus is on us to truly repent. Turn to God. And cease from all ungodly habits and practices. We cannot just ask God to purify us and continue consciously doing the same things that we were doing before we asked for purification, before this time of prayer and fasting. We may have been involved in things that I have just listed here. We can't go back. The songwriter says, I won't go back. I can't go back to the way I used to be before your presence came and changed. Before your presence came and changed me, it's a conscious decision. I won't go back. I can't go back to the way it used to be before your presence came and changed me. Too many changes have taken place in my life, God, and I can't afford it. To go back. We can't continue in the same things. I heard Pastor Greg say some time ago, insanity is doing the same thing in the same way every time and expecting a different result. Change. Transformation. We have to decide to change. We have to decide. Nobody can decide for us. We have to recognize this is where I am impure. This is where I am doing things that don't please God. And this is where I need to change. Where I need to change might not be where you need to change because we are different. But I have to recognize for myself, you have to recognize for yourself, this is what is besetting me. This is what is tripping me up. This is what is causing me to stop running in this race. And this is what I have to get rid of. This is where I need. This is where I need to be purified. And stop looking at other people where they need to be purified. Because we look at the outward appearance, but God looks at the heart. So we don't need to look at anybody else. We need to check ourselves because we can't purify anybody. Hey, they have to come to God for themselves. And so we come to him and we have to decide to change. God will not change us against our will. We make the choice to live pure and we make the decision to change. Purify my heart. Oh Lord, create within me a clean heart and purify me in the name of Jesus. Father, we come to you this morning. We bring everything at your feet. Lord, you said we should present our bodies as a living sacrifice. Because you know, Makareboshah, that our bodies, Lord God, will get in front of the spirit sometimes. The body and the spirit, Lord, the flesh and the spirit are contrary the one to the other. So, Lord, you said we need to present our bodies as living sacrifices, holy and acceptable unto you, which is our reasonable service. Help us not to be conformed to this world, but Lord, help us to be transformed by the renewing of our mind, that we may prove what is that good and acceptable and perfect will of God. We come to you this morning, God. We get rid of everything, Lord God, that is unlike you. We shake it off, mighty God. We cast it off, mighty God. We strip it off, mighty God. And we make a conscious decision that we want to live pure. We want to live holy. We want to live sanctified lives, mighty God. Hear us this morning, God. Purify us. Have your way in our lives as we give ourselves to you. One more time. In Jesus' name, amen. The Lord bless you.